So you're either dipping into that trust fund that you've been holding on to, or you just like looking at overly priced things. Maybe you're just morbidly curious. I don't know. But I went on PCPartPicker.com and put together the most extravagant, expensive build I could. And with Apple releasing their Mac that can potentially go up to $50,000, I thought I should make something that would trump that. Now, a few things that I should explain before breaking down this list. One, I did not buy these parts, obviously, because I'm poor. Two, I chose AMD over Intel because, frankly, their higher performing chips are just higher performing chips than Intel, even though Intel's Xeon processors tend to be more expensive than AMD's Threadrippers. Two, or is it three? Either way. I chose Threadripper over the EPYC processors because Threadripper for a 32-core processor has a much higher clock than their EPYC processors, even though some of the EPYC processors are more expensive. And there are boards that support the EPYC processors that have dual sockets. And I felt that one Threadripper at 32 cores and boosting up to 4 gigahertz on a board is enough to start with. So, I know Tom's gonna be annoyed with me, but you're just gonna have to live with it. So, this is relatively the most expensive computer I could build that would still be useful. Okay, now as I mentioned, I have picked the AMD Threadripper 2990WX 32-core processor. Now, it's a 3 gigahertz processor that boosts up to 4, which is crazy with 32 cores. It is $1,617.11. At least in this length. The cooler to cool this massive beast is the most expensive cooler I could find that was a liquid cooler. Is the Asus ROG Ryujin 360 121.8 CMF liquid CPU cooler. It can like cool things really good, and that's $277.17. I guess I should like explain some of this stuff better. It's got like, you know, the Aorus lights, so you know, your cooling stuff could be super cool and pretty and beautiful, because that matters. It matters. And if you're buying such an expensive chip, you might as well get a good cooler. Now, the Asus ROG Zenith Extreme E-ATX Threadripper motherboard. Now this thing is nice. So not only does it support Threadripper, it has 4 PCIe slots and 8 RAM DIMMs. And it supports up to 3200 MHz of clock speed from the RAM, but we're not going with that. We're going with 8 16GB CORSAIR Vengeance LPX 128GB of RAM clocked at 4000 MHz. Now I know that the new Mac blah 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 can support up to 1.5 TB of RAM, but well, I doubt you'll ever need that for just about anything. And it's not just about needing it. 128 is a lot, and it's gonna take a lot to even just need that unless you're doing very advanced projects. But clock speed does matter with RAM, and 4000 is ridiculously fast for RAM. That's like 3 times faster than my RAM sticks, so you know. I think that kind of matters. So when you're pairing extremely fast RAM at 128 gigabytes, that's plenty for an OP system. There was 6 SSD drive bays, so why not get the Samsung 860 Pro 4 terabyte drives? They're really expensive. They're like $917 each, so might as well fill it up, you know? But we're not stopping there at storage. We also got the Samsung 972TB M.2 slots. Now this is NVMe as well, because this board has 3 NVMe slots, which is glorious. We got three 2TB drives out of that. So all total, we have 30TB of storage. Should hold us for a little bit. Now for the graphics cards. There is 4 slots. I guess I could get 4. So the PNY Quadro GV100 32GB video card. That's a $10,560 card. So we'll get 2. I don't even know if 4 is supported. I don't know if you can technically. Can you? Someone let me know if this board can actually handle 4 of these things running. I don't know if there's like enough bandwidth on the PCIe's cards to handle more than 64 gigabytes of video memory. I don't know. Someone let me know if that's feasible, because we could easily add another 20,000 to this, making it a $53,000 computer. So, I don't know. There is more PCIe slots, but I mean, this is ridiculous. Okay, and the power supply. We're going with the Corsair 1600 watt 80 plus titanium certified fully modular ATX power supply. This is a chunky boy. It's gonna take the whole power slot thingy. So the estimated power consumption of this build is around 1100 watts. So 1600 just to be safe, because you're probably gonna wanna overclock these things. And 1600 watts is about as high as I can find without it getting really weird. So we're gonna go with that. That power supply, my friends, is $459.98. I just made a PC build guide for $500, and this power supply is almost all of that. And all the other videos I made about getting an OS and just using the media creation tool, yeah, you're not gonna do that. No. If you're blowing this money, you're gonna spend $139 on buying Microsoft Windows 10 Pro. I didn't mention the case. Now, this is where I could have spent more, but kind of needlessly. When you've got all these beautiful parts, you want to show them off the right way. Now, the most expensive case I could find was around $1,000, but it wasn't that nice looking. It was just like a cage, and I don't think it was full metal or anything. So I was like, well, what's the fun in that? So I settled on the very beautiful Thermaltake Tower 900 ATX, full tower case. Now, it's what many refer to as a refrigerator case, where it's a big cage with a glass box that showcases everything beautifully. And that's what it is. It's a beautiful build. You're gonna wanna show it off. It has a really cool compartment in the back where it kinda draws the air out of the front end of the cage. Especially with the water cooling solutions in the back, it ventilates out the back and pulls the air out. So it does handle that pretty nicely. And this case is around $250. So surprisingly, not too much of a baller case for this build, but I thought it was appropriate because it had what it needs and it shows everything off on the inside pretty well. Now, like I mentioned earlier, there were some price cuts because I had to be sure of compatibility on some things, and I'm just not as familiar with what is compatible with an EPYC processor and dual socket boards. I just don't know enough about that. You could play around with that a little bit more. You could surely get a more expensive build, but practically this is one of the most expensive builds you can get that I know would work and definitely remains useful without just being kind of ridiculous. Now, that Threadripper chip is amazing, and I'd love to see it in action. I believe there's another one coming out in a couple of months, so this one may become obsolete, but you know, whatever. So, what would you think? Would this PC be a better build than whatever Max got going on? $32,000, $33,000 is no small chunk of change, but with this thing, you could probably do some pretty crazy stuff. I mean, at this point, it just turns into 3D modeling and animation and rendering. This is a rendering machine, really. Well, if you like this video, leave a thumbs up and let me know what you think about it. I know that these types of lists offer a little bit of controversy and opinion, so be nice. This is a theoretical list. And if you're interested in checking any of these parts out, I will be leaving links in the description below. So until the next video, guys, I will see you later.